Hi, I'm Matt Russell with the University of Minnesota Extension, and we're here today to talk about doing an inventory plot here at the Cloquet Forestry Center. We're standing in about a 25-year-old red pine stand with some deadwood on the forest floor, some red pine seedlings, and some jack pine in the overstory as well. Okay, well, one of the common tools we use in forest inventory is a tape to measure the size of our plots. What we're using today is a 100-foot fiberglass tape. Now, if you don't have one of these, easily a tape measure will do to measure the size of your fixed radius plots. For our plots, for our 1/20th of an acre plot, we'll use 26.3 feet. For our 1/50th of an acre plot, we'll use 16.7 feet. And if you don't have a tape like this or measuring tape, you can simply measure out those distances using a piece of string or a piece of yarn to help you have something to carry in your woods to find out how far away you are from your plot center.
Hi, I'm Mike Reichenbach. I'm with the University of Minnesota Extension, Extension Educator, and we're at the Cloquet Forestry Center. We're standing in a red pine stand that's probably 25 to 30 years old. And we're going to demonstrate how to do an inventory or count the number of trees we have. And so, Matt, if you would come up here, and I'm standing at what will be plot center, which we found as a random spot in the woods. But Matt, if you take this out, 26.3 feet. That's right at. Yep. Okay. And so this is 26.3 feet. And so that's the diameter of a plot that is a 20th of an acre. And so what I'd like to do then is we'll count all the trees that are within this radius, and we'll start going counterclockwise. You can go either way. So knowing that there's eight trees and we're in a 20th of an acre plot radius, we'd go ahead and multiply that by 20 and come up with 160 trees per acre.
Okay, so here at the Cloquet Forestry Center, we own 24 acres of land that look very similar to this. It's this 25-year-old, 30-year-old red pine stand that was planted, some jack pine mixed in. And so what we did, Mike and I calculated eight trees in our 1/20th of an acre inventory plot. And so what that means is that if we take those eight trees and multiply by 20, we would get 160 trees per acre that's representative of the forest that we owned. And further, if we take that 160 trees per acre, multiply it by the 24 acres that we own across our entire property, what's the final number, Mike?
Final number is 3,840 trees.
Great. 3,840 trees are found on our property. Based on this small sample that we collected in this 1/20th of an acre inventory plot.
So, in addition to small trees, you can use a smaller plot radius to figure out what your young trees, young growth coming up are. And this can include seedlings. So we're going to go ahead and use a 50th of an acre plot, which is 16.7 feet radius, and see if we find any seedlings within that radius or any smaller trees. We'll also go ahead and count the big trees to see how the two compare.
Good, so Mike and I just counted the seedlings that we found in our inventory plot, in our 1/50th of an acre inventory plot. We counted six seedlings. So if we multiply six by 50, That is to say, each seedling represents 50 seedlings that might be found on a per acre basis. We get 300 seedlings per acre. Now, if we know that our property is 24 acres in size, if we multiply that 300 number by 24, we've got 7,200 seedlings on our property. And most of those seedlings look like they're red pine. There might be some jack pine scattered through here as well. And so this goes to show you that even though we measured more trees in our overstory plot, we measured 8 trees in our 1/20th of an acre plot, we're actually finding more seedlings per acre because the smaller plot size that we used just indicated that they're more abundant than the larger size trees.